This will be a demonstration of how to troubleshoot the measurement of a voltage output sensor. So what we have here is a serial 1000X data logger, and all the link connected is a sensor which has two single-ended voltage outputs. This sensor also requires 12 volts power. Some sensors might be running off 5 volts or 3 volts, while other sensors may be self-powered. Then you'll also have some ground connections in your signals. So to troubleshoot the measurement of such a sensor, you'll need your wiring diagram for your program, which gives the specific channel numbers where the different wires should be connected. And you'll also want to know what wire does what. So I'm interested in the yellow signal in this sensor. It is going to be the yellow wire is the temperature signal in this case, and the blue wire is a humidity signal. So I'm going to be looking at the voltages on these two, and that's going to be referenced to one of the grounds. And you'll need some way to look at the measurements on the data logger. So it could be a laptop that's connected. It could be the LoggerLink mobile app. Or in this case, I have a keypad display, and I can see the current readings on this data logger. So what I'll do is you need a multimeter. And this is a really inexpensive model. Any model should be able to measure these signals. You'll find your dial. You'll want to set to a range that's bigger than the signal, but not needlessly so. So the signals from this sensor are actually maximum of 1 volt. And so I'm actually going to put on this 2000 millivolt range. And I'm going to switch this on. And we've got two leads. These make sure what your ground lead is connected to your comm on your ground. That's your reference. And your red lead is connected to one that's labeled as for using with voltage measurements, in which case is marked with a V. And this is a DC voltage I'm measuring. So you arrange it where you can see your display easily. And you'll just put your reference probe on one of your grounds. And these screw terminals, if they're closed, you can get good electrical contact. If I was to put this on an open terminal, the loose screw can not be a very good electrical contact. So you want to put it on one that's closed, or you can also hold it against the ground lug. So I'm going to use this ground terminal, and I will check the yellow, which will be my temperature signal. And that's reading 662. So I'm going to make a note of that. And at the same time, I need to look at my display and make a note of what my temperature is right now. And my temperature, according to my display, is 25.6. Okay. All right, then I'm going to check my other signal. And that's reading 179, and these are in millivolts on my meter. I'm on a millivolt range. And according to my display, that is 17.8. on the humidity. Yeah. So now at that point, you're done taking your measurements, but then you have to do some math. The nice thing about voltage output sensors is I did not have to disconnect anything, and it did not interrupt the data logger's measurements. With some other types of sensors, you may have to disconnect them. But with voltage output sensors, you just leave them connected, but you need to know which wires are which. Particularly since a sensor needs power, if I had it disconnected, I wouldn't be able to measure the outputs. So then let's just convert the readings. So I have a 662 millivolts, and you need to know the multipliers and offsets for your program. And this in this program, the temperature has a multiplier of 0.1, and that'll be times the 662, and it has an offset of minus 40. So then that would be 66.2 minus 40, which would be 26.2 C, which is pretty close to the day logger measurement. Now it's important to note your meter may read close, but be off a bit and still be indicating the data logger is working correctly. Because your data logger is a very high accuracy voltmeter. And unless your multimeter you're using is an expensive model, the accuracy is going to be much lower than the data logger. So we're looking for close agreement, not exact numbers. Now the humidity, we had the 179 millivolts, and this one has a multiplier also of 0.1, but this one also has an offset of 0. So that's going to be 17.9% humidity, which is really close to what the data logger reported. So what this indicates is the data logger is reading the sensor correctly. If these readings do not look right, then you're going to have to compare the sensor to another sensor. If you've got another sensor with you, say a duplicate sensor, you could swap out the sensor if you suspect its readings are bad. Or it could be, say, a secondary sensor where you can co-locate it. A handheld temperature meter might get you roughly in the range. But again, the accuracy of it, you'd have to be mindful of the accuracy of the sensor connected to the data logger versus a handheld meter. Because the difference can be quite a bit, especially since the mounting of the sensor can affect it. So in this case, the data logger program is running correctly. The data logger hardware is running well, and I'm getting good readings.